Hey everyone, this is my fourth vlog, and again, just a disclaimer for everyone out there looking at this video. These set of videos on my vlog, on my doctoring story, is my opinion and my perspective. This is not an attempt to make anyone, my birth family or my adopted family, to look bad in any way. I know where my loyalties lie, and you need to understand that there's no right or wrong way in dealing with this, especially when, you know, you're trying to search for your birth family. As well, and going for adoptive parents, you know, you just need to understand that there's a curiosity within your child that they need to figure out, and that they need to basically satisfy. It's something that they're entitled to and have a right to. And my intent is not to say, hey, how you should raise your kids, because that's your business. But what I'm saying is that's something that's theirs and theirs alone. And if it serves them to satisfy that curiosity, then you need to step aside. You really do. If they choose to include you, then you should embrace that. As a parent, you should embrace it, not deny it. Because the worst thing that you could do is deny your child that privilege, that right. I was privileged to at least had parents that were accepting of that. Yes, there were disagreements, but it's important to know that just because they're searching doesn't mean that they don't love you. It just means that they're trying to find a piece of themselves that is hanging on your shoulders, but they can't understand it until they find it. I know it's cryptic, but that's just how I see it. You know, one of the most important things that my adopted mom told me as I was searching, She told me once, be careful what you're looking for, because you may not like what you find. You know, that was during the time of when we clashed. And during that time, you know, my mom and I clashed a lot. And when she said that, you know, I interpreted that as, I don't want you to find your birth family. But what she was really saying was, listen, I'm worried for you, because if you find them, what if you see something that is so deplorable that it may hurt you? You know, it's a mother's responsibility to protect their kids. And unfortunately, my mom passed away, my adopted mom passed away in 2001. I didn't fully understand what she was trying to say until after I got reacquainted with my birth family. And I'm kicking myself in the butt for that. Because there are many times that she would try to tell me, listen, you know, take it easy, you're going to find them, but you know, you really need to cool it, you know, take your time, you know. I didn't understand why she would say that to me. Unfortunately, it takes until after someone's gone sometimes to fully comprehend what they're trying to show you and teach you. And my mom was trying to do something that I didn't understand. At that time, I couldn't understand it. I don't think I would have. And even even now, as I look back and I see what she was trying to say versus what's happening now in my life with my biological siblings, she was right. She really was. I found out that my biological siblings, excuse me, were physically abused, emotionally abused. Some of them were actually sexually abused. Anything that you can think of. And it's very, very disheartening to know that, to come to learn that. And some of the choices that my biological siblings have made in life, I disagree with, and I don't like it. I really don't. It hurts me because as I look back and as I look back to what my adoptive mom told me, I wish I had listened, and I wished also that she would communicate to me, listen, we don't want you to get hurt. We want you to find them, but we want you to be careful. Don't get me wrong, I'm very happy that I found my birth family. Actually, technically, they found me. But that's another vlog. I'm very satisfied that now I'm beginning to satisfy my curiosity of where I come from, my likes and dislikes, and how they relate to my biological siblings. All the questions that I had when I was younger are being answered. They're being answered slowly, some painfully, some joyfully, but in all, I'm satisfied and content. I would say that as a if you're as an adoptee, if you're looking for your birth parents, communicate to your adoptive parents your intent. Your intent is not to leave them. Your intent is to simply satisfy a curiosity, to find something that belongs to you, because it does. Don't let anyone tell you that it doesn't, because it does. Likewise, your adoptive parents should be able to communicate to you whether or not they're okay with it. Some parents are very fearful, and there's a good reason. There really is, and you have to understand that. They're very fearful to lose you. Some parents may see that as you being ungrateful. But you have to reiterate that, listen, I'm not being ungrateful. I'm simply trying to find a piece of a puzzle. And you have to make that clear. You really do. It's very important. It's equally more important to also make sure your siblings understand where you're coming from, because they will clash with you. I certainly clash with my siblings, and it was all because of miscommunication. That's all it boiled down to. We both sides, I didn't communicate my true intent, and they didn't communicate their true intent. To them, it was just a reaction. Excuse me, to me, it was just a reaction to what I was doing. And to me, it looked like they just didn't want me to find my biological family. But in reality, what they were saying was, listen, we love you so much that we don't want to lose you. That's what they were saying. And sometimes you have to take a step back to not hear what they're saying, but listen to what they're saying. It's unfortunate that, again, it took many years afterwards to come to that realization. And likewise for them, you know, I wish that they took a step back a little bit to understand where I was coming from. I don't think in my right mind I would have just said, "All right, bye bye guys. I found my biological family. Peace out." No. There was much more to lose if I ever did such a thing. There's too much emotional investment. There was too much to lose, and that is the family. And they did the best they could to keep the family together, under the circumstances. That's all I have to say. Looking back now, I wish I could tell my mom that she was right. She was right. She was very, very right. And unfortunately, I can't tell her that now. And I can't tell her how much I appreciate what she did for me and how thankful that I am. And I can't tell her, you know, I found what I was looking for, and that there are some things that I like, and there are some things that are hurtful and I don't like. So that's that. And I look forward to your comments, criticisms. Yeah, peace.